If you take a look inside on a box, you see how this is still attached on its backside, okay? It's not attached on the front side. So the easiest knockout to take out is this one, because you can see that pressure. Now I opened it up, okay? The difference with this one here is just because of how it's positioned in there. And what happens is, if they get too far back, they'll end up taking that 3/4 inch knockout out. And when they do that, now the box is gonna have to have a reducing washer, or they're gonna get another box. Bringing this up, and again, everybody's got different ways of doing it. Some will take a pair of linesmen's and a screwdriver, what we call a beater, and everybody has one. And that beater will allow you to take and punch this out. And once you get it broke out loose, just break it out. And putting the connector on. And of course, having to do it with gloves is a challenge. Now, we're just gonna leave it loose for now. But again, in order for this to maintain electrical continuity on grounding, that has to be tight, okay? And regrettably, what we do is, again, we take a screwdriver, preferably a beater, not an 11-in-1, and we bring it up snug. Now, you can beat this for a half hour. It's not gonna get any tighter than what it is when you take and initially do it. When I take, come around, I wanna see my set screw straight out in front. Okay, that way there, everything is symmetrical. It looks like it was done on purpose. So if I'm running conduit down here, I got two options. I'm either gonna use a one hole strap and I'm gonna strap it tight to the stud, or I'm gonna use a mini. If I use a mini, I don't have to worry about a box offset. If I use a one hole strap, now I gotta worry about a box offset bringing that pipe so she's gonna sit flush on the wall, okay? Whereas with the mini, I can come right out of the connector and drop straight down, okay? And that'll give me my first support. With the one hole strap, obviously it's gonna set up against the stud itself. Now I gotta get from here to the back of that stud. So it's a box offset. And box offset is back, is a 10 degree offset. I don't worry about take up on the, or shrinkage on it, only because of the fact that it's such a small offset, and I'm gonna do it as the first bend of my pipe. So that's 28 inches from the floor to the bottom of the box. I'm gonna take a little bit off that so I make sure I fit inside the connector. I mean, and everybody has a little bit different, you know, view of this. If you come too close to the shoe or the horn or the hook, and back here, you could egg shape it out because if you put too much pressure on it. So just trying to take and, you know, I like do about an inch, you know, for my box offset. That way I know I'm straight pipe going up into the connector. And so I set up a 10 degree, you know, you're barely going to put any pressure on it. But the one thing, you see how you wobble, you want to try and make sure you get pressure on the horn and pressure on the back here. So that when you bring it up, you want your leg and your arm to do the work at the same time. Okay. And you want to get it just by the sight. You're going to use your 10 degree angle over on the side, and that's going to show you if you're at 10 degrees or not. So you want that to be horizontal, okay? You're going to get a little bit of kickback on EMT, so if you go over just a hair, don't worry about it, it'll kick back on you. And once you do the first bend, All I do is just roll it and I come in. Now the hard part is making sure you're far enough away from this first bend so you're not taking that bend out. The other part you got to think about, dog legs, okay? And dog leg is if you don't line up your pipe right where the back of the bend was here. People have used a no dog, a wow watcher, a level. Some just do it by sight. And you're just trying to line it up. Again, 10 degree, so foot pressure at the same time that you're pulling back. I'm gonna run with it. I marked my conduit, and that shows me that's the back of my offset. So when I take and I go to do my 90 degree, I know where to line it up at. We get 28 inches from the bottom of the box to the floor. I've already got my box offset into it. So now I'm gonna take and measure it out. 28 inches, I got a 3/4 inch bender, 6 inch take up. So I could do 22, and I take just a little bit off that. So now I'm gonna do a 90. And yet there's my box offset. My 90 is coming away, so I need to roll this. Okay, I'm taking and lining up my mark with my arrow. That's a start from my 90. I've taken away my 6 inches from my 28, so I'm at 22. And again, same thing, foot pressure. You can tell if you don't have foot pressure when you get the 90 up, you'll have a ripple in it. And everybody's a little bit different in how they're gonna bend it. You see my 90, I'm straight up and down. Got the bubble in between the lines. You see down here, it's smooth, no ripples, so you got the right foot pressure. If you can look down inside the fitting here, you can see the end of the pipe. And it's a little bit more than an eighth of an inch away, a little bit more of what I want. So you got to get used to your bender. You get practice with it and understand what it can do. Just because it has marks on it, if you move your pipe, you know, an eighth of an inch, a 16th of an inch, it could affect what your bend is going to be. If you overbend the pipe, it's going to affect it. It's going to be higher. If your bend 90 is open and pulled away from the wall, then your pipe is actually gonna be shorter, okay? So this one here is tight, box offset's good, and we're just over eighth of an inch from the end of the pipe. So good pipe, we would install it, we would use it, we'd pull wire through it.